Save some time. I converted the US General cart we had, so my boss gave it to me. So I'm using it for my bodywork supplies. All my body stuff's in that US General cart. I'll give you a quick tour. Got two grinders set up, one with a cutting blade, one with a flapper disc for grinding. This flapper disc is way better than I thought for leveling off welds. I didn't think it'd be very durable for it. I bought a box of 10 and I've been using this on everything I've ground so far. It's been holding up good. Got my hammers and dollies handy. My soap marker, this is great for welding. You can weld over, it doesn't hurt anything. Got some pliers. Of course, I got my new welding helmet. You guys saw that in the last video, I think. Miscellaneous brushes and putty knives and more of the soapstone markers and stuff like that. Disposable brushes for any chemicals I don't have to brush. What else we got? All my sanding supplies are in this drawer. Plenty of these discs, but I'm gonna have to get some more. These wear out pretty fast. The flappers seem to last for quite a while. And I bought these for sanding small areas. But I'm not sure if I have anything else in here other than the stuff on the bottom. Oh, I brought in my Tack Life, which is a Dremel replica. Bought these on Amazon for $16. They were $25 at Home Depot. Same exact thing. And then, of course, at the bottom's all my chemicals and paints and stuff like that. So, but anyway, I just want to show you guys that real quick. Because I come in on Sundays and set this up to work on it, having that cart, that saves me a bunch of time. Otherwise, I'd have all my stuff dispersed in the 3 or 4 toolboxes I have. That thing saves me probably half an hour just setting up. So all I got to do is grab my cameras, roll this out here, and hook up a fan. If it's hot like today, it's pretty hot. It's about 93 right now and climbing. It's 11 o'clock in the morning. Cut the grass, took my wife grocery shopping, and here I am with you guys. Let's grab some metal and start doing some cutting and welding. That's the fun part. All right, guys, I got the welder set up. I'm gonna just start doing a little weld, and I got my clamps on in place. So I'm just gonna fix this little corner. It's something you won't even see once it's bolted on, but I want it to be structurally sound. So it's gotta be right in my head, even if you can't see it. That's just how I work. So let's get the welder going. This is what that panel looks like, a little patch I made. Covers the hole that was in here. So, if you can see that, I hope. Finding a place to put your ground is sometimes a problem, but you always gotta, sometimes if you have to, you can tack a piece of coat hanger or a piece of metal to the panel you're working on, clamp it to that, and then just cut it off and grind it smooth afterwards. But let's get to welding. Got to turn it on first. That's better. This is where that hole was. I think we got it pretty good. I just put a small piece of metal behind it. Kind of butt welded it up against it, so the wheel well mounts on flush, so it won't hurt anything to put a little metal behind there. Made it easy to fill that hole. Let's keep going. You always want to try to give yourself 3 or 4 inches so that you don't try to pull the metal up by getting it too hot. So far so good. Probably went a little too fast on this panel. Got to slow myself down. All right, I got quite a bit of it welded. Still got a couple spaces I got to do, but I want to do some grinding before I finish the welding. When you grind, you find a weld you missed, and you find the welds that were a little porous or missed a tiny spot. And if you wait and grind 100% of it, you're still going to find missing spots, and you're going to get it hotter. I've actually already probably welded a little too much, but definitely time to grind now. I don't want to push it any further. It's going to take about an hour and a half, so I'm not going to record the whole thing, but I'll bring a clip in every few minutes, maybe every 15 minutes or so. Keep in mind, when I'm doing this, I'm not pressing. If you press on the welds, it'll grind faster, but it'll generate more heat. You don't want too much heat. It's not as critical, obviously, on an inner bed panel, but who knows what it'll do to the whole bed panel if something really bad happens and the metal wants to buckle. So, motor avoids some heat. Alright, now we're getting somewhere. Alright, I got my welding and grinding done pretty much here. I got quite a warp in this, so I hammered the crap out of it. I'm gonna go over that and smooth that out a little bit. But for today, I think I'm gonna put some etching primer and some red color primer. I fixed up the rest of my stake pocket, so that came out pretty good. And I gotta do a little more work on my panel here. I started grinding that out to get a little more contour, and it looks like there's a couple of light spots. And it's going back on like that. I'm probably gonna paint, I'm either gonna replace this emblem, or I'm gonna paint this. It's black in here and red in here. It's pitted pretty bad, but kind of goes with the theme of the truck, although I want a few shiny bits on it. I'll think about that one. Let's finish this up for now. I think that is, we're now currently in a no bare metal situation. I'm gonna let that set up and dry. Then I'm gonna sand it a little bit and go over it with the red rust preventative primer. We gotta give this probably about 15, 20 minutes to set up. All right, I'm gonna spray some of my rusty metal primer. Use on heavily rusted metal for the ultimate finish. Chip Foose will be like, whoa. Well, all right, maybe not, but it'll look better. I need to stop looking at this piece. I find a new hole every time I look at it. Probably also not the best body hammer. Yeah, that's terrible. We're gonna fix it right up. Now, truck's got pinstriping in places and stuff, which was done obviously a long time ago, but it was put over the rust. Someone put it on there to make it fancy. So I'm gonna try to save some of that and leave what I can on. I might even try to duplicate it if I'm feeling adventurous in spots where I had to grind it off or something. But we'll cross that bridge when we get to it. I don't care for those marks that separate the rust from the paint. So I'm gonna probably go over a lot of those, but not all of them. All right. This metal's coated, these panels, they're coated rust preventative, like a zinc coating, I think it is. But I'm gonna still put a little primer on them, so when I spray rhino lining on these bed panels, it'll have something to grab onto. I think primer is gonna be better than whatever that coating is. This is a little bit hack, but I don't wanna fabricate the whole bottom corner. And it's got only had a few little soft spots. I put my grinder in them and ground them out to see how far out they went before they got a little structurally strong. So I took a piece of metal and I bent it to form inside the piece, the corner. Instead of making the whole piece have to be beautiful, I'm gonna use it as fill so I can back weld it. And then I can grind the welds down and smooth out everything. There won't be any holes left that way. It'll be fine. And there's extra metal in there. If it does turn out to be a little soft somewhere I missed, there's metal behind it. I can weld it to it and we'll fix it right up. This is an alternative to replacing this whole back panel or trying to fabricate something with multiple compound bends. So let's see how it goes. All right, here's a piece I cut out of there. Pretty ragged. This is the piece I made. I left a little extra metal on there to hold it. I got it pretty close. So let's get to welding this thing in. I'm gonna get it tack welded in, get it all set, and then I just cut off the end and we're done. If you cut the end off ahead of time, when you try to weld at the end, it'll always leave a little divot. If I leave an extra metal and then cutting it off after, you won't see that the weld ended there or anything like that. So should be just a matter of getting that welder going now. Kind of got this going along nicely. Figured I'd bring you guys in and show you as I finish up. I'm gonna tack these together now just so that the two pieces aren't flopping around. I think from the factory they're spot welded and they've rusted so much that it pulled away. I'm just gonna put a couple tacks on it just to strengthen it. Hopefully it doesn't burn through. Ah, that's a bummer. Well, it started out as a tack. Turned into fill the hole. Just grind that down a little bit so it doesn't interfere when I bolt it back up. And I think we're pretty good. You guys fall on the ground. I dropped the mic. Sorry about that. I'm gonna let this cool a little bit. I'll dress it, and then I'll see if it needs a little more work, or I'm gonna leave it there. All right, now what I'm doing here, obviously, if you're building a top dollar show truck, this isn't how you wanna do it. Probably, I mean, honestly, most people aren't ever gonna see what's behind that quarter panel, but you could cut a piece of metal in strips this way, like a piece this way, and then make this piece, and then make that piece. That's how somebody who's really good at this, like Fitzy, would probably do it. Matter of fact, what I'm gonna do in this next piece here, that's kind of a Fitzy trick too. He's way better at metal than I am. I'm still an amateur. I enjoy doing it, actually, especially because I don't have to pay someone else to fix my truck, right? But one of the tricks that I learned from him was, like, I jammed a piece of metal through there. Instead of taking half an hour fabricating a curved piece of metal, I took a square piece of metal, I jammed it through the slot where I wanted to connect it to the new piece I have down here. And once I get it welded up, I'll just grind that off and I'll have my correctly shaped piece of metal. Minus a half hour or so of fabrication for a little tiny piece of metal nobody can see. I'm only fixing these little holes because I know they're there. Get the old welding helmet on so I don't get weld burn. Oh, you gotta hook up your ground. One of the handy things about these pliers, they'll hold the metal and they'll give you a good ground. I'll weld it. I'm gonna weld it on the inside too in case grinding it off makes it too weak. I might get time to go in the pool today after all. Essentially what I'm doing is, think of it like a spot weld. You have two panels together. I'm spot welding the panel behind it, that's all. It's just to make the filling the weld, the rust hole, which obviously, like I said, I ground out the really soft stuff. And basically, using the back panel to fill the rust hole easy to make sure not take... If I fabricated that panel that I just did that in about, what, five minutes, 10 minutes? If I cut that piece off and fabricated it, I'd have a couple of 3 hours in it, so... I'll take that method. I got a couple more to do, and I'm gonna make a panel for the little bottom edge. And then all I need is that wheel well panel, and it's supposed to come any day now. I got this flat piece made, and all I gotta do now is make the piece that faces this way towards the tantalite panel. I made the flat piece. Now I'm gonna make the back piece so that you can't see in there. And I gotta make a couple little more pieces and we're done for today, I think. I'm getting kind of tired. It's been like 4 hours. Fill weld a couple more over here. Panel. All right, guys, I got this all welded up. I'm gonna cut this off even with my cutoff wheel, do a little cleanup work if I can get that done today. Just a heads up, the weather is rolling in. You can see the trees are whipping in the distance and the dirt devils are coming by. It's the wind is picking up, the storms are coming. So I'm gonna give this another 5 or 10 minutes. If it starts raining heavy, I'm gonna say goodbye to you guys now. And this video right here, just in case. If I get to film some more, I'll edit it in. you'll get to see that finished up. So I appreciate you guys watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Torque the like button below. That'll help me help the channel grow. And maybe subscribe if you want to see more project truck videos, auto repair, tool reviews, all kinds of videos. And sometimes I combine them. So hope to see you guys in the next video. You're awesome.